Welcome to the 24th annual recital event in Holland. Since 1990 was my first one, and I didn't have one because of surgery 1 year. It still makes it 24 though, even though it's 24 years back. It looks like a 24 now, but it's 24 years, 24th annual recital. Does everyone have a program? We all have one. Everyone. And we got, I probably put 50 to them. Okay. Let me refer you to the program for just a moment. If you take your program for a second, you'll notice that some people have two numbers. I would appreciate if you hold your applause until they're done, rather than just the first number. Okay? And then if you turn the program, you'll see that the top one, Stephen, also has two movements to it. That's naturally how they always do after, you know. But don't applaud until he's done with the round. I would appreciate that. So everybody's got two, which are most of the younger ones. And that one. All right. Wonderful. I'll keep it. Special thanks for the credits. I know I put it down, but I appreciate, of course, Ventura letting us use their facility for the last 8 or 9 years. All I can say, I've got a little note down there, but please leave it in as good, if not better, condition when you find it. Which means, kids, don't leave anything around. This, I sort of used this for our color this year. It was like effervescent, glow in the dark. So please don't leave any of this around. Janitors may come in and do some things before our service tomorrow. But okay. Thank you to our photographer, Ms. Elizabeth Brumley, our video by Mr. Michael Sims. He did it last year and he put a real nice video up for us. Refreshments, the Busman family. I'm not going to have them stand and embarrass them, but they're my four newest students. But they just started in the first week in April, so if I would have known they were going to go so fast, I would have had them play, but their mother was not as leaving me on that anyway. And a set of crew, Chris Bushman, not the kids. They were outside playing. But also, everything Thomas did first for Motto. Appreciate you guys a lot. There's a couple of different elements today, so some of you did this recital, so some of you will find something different from what we've ever done before. Maybe the last time they have to do it too. We'll find out. I may try to make this announcement one more time afterwards, but if after the recital, three or four guys who do not have back trouble. Here's your way out, I suppose, too. But if you would help, it's not hard to move it. We're going to move it back in the corner where our piano generally is. Okay? If I could have five or six just sit in the way, so we don't need a lot. So if you want to supervise, you can give up the fifth one. I would encourage all of you, if all possible, to stay for just a little time with your friends. I'd like to meet you too, some I don't know. So if you can't, it won't be as long as normal because we're having refreshments rather than a luncheon, a full-scale luncheon. I would really appreciate it. Okay, and I think that's all I've got to say before the recital begins. Thomas Tremonto is going to lead us in a word of prayer, as we've always done from our recitals at the very beginning. And after that, his daughter, Tabitha, and his wife, she's going to start too, I guess, are going to play a duet. And from there on, kids, it's one after each other. But at least let them get stood up before you come down, okay? But no announcing, all right? Good job. Okay, Thomas? You want mine?
Father God, we are humbled to be able to come to you and know that you have brought us together. For with Bob's heart, just music, but teaching them obedience to their parents, teaching them about your son, Jesus Christ, teaching them about all the things that, that you have decided to be good for us in our growth. Lord, we come to you in awe, knowing that, that you both loved us with the Spirit to guide men and fathers, and the Spirit to guide our children, and to draw them close to you. So Lord, we pray as we listen to this music, that we would not only be appreciated in this towards their hard work, the discipline that they have day by day to practice and learn, but also the work for the heart behind this music, and that we would see you in it, Lord, that we would look towards the future where these kids might play and the music might touch someone, even in a way that they can speak about you, and whether it's done through the music or the teacher that taught them and the love behind it, but Lord, that we, through this music, we would be glorified. And Lord, that's what we truly hope for. We give you thanks and pray you that this day we need for more fellowship, and we look forward to that as well. In Jesus Christ. Amen.
Just one more thing, I'm sorry. As you notice down here, names that everybody plays, the Romans are ruling. Looks like everybody's there. But the thing is that some of you don't know, the Fermatos are also related. And so the two mothers are sisters. And you'll notice three have asterisks after their name. They're not my students, but they're aunt's students. Another Romney, except it's not Romney. Christiana, she's here today. She's going to help me at the end, okay? So she'll come up and she's got a 5-minute speech all prepared. So, no, she doesn't. Thank you. That's the first time I heard that number. I came into the Robin Gardens at Fermata's house one day, unknowingly to this young lady, and snuck in on her, because I knew that if she knew I came, she'd do something. Quit playing and sit on the couch. And I teach right there at the Fermata's. And I didn't know what was going to be, to be honest with you. I knew Thomas didn't play like that. And I knew Jennifer probably did it. And the kids certainly did it. So I said, what are you doing? Because I never heard that anything like that. And this is not to put her down at all, but she really, the lessons we had, she didn't play that well. She said, I made it up. She just made up a number. She just made up a number for her. I never heard of her. And I just wanted to, I asked her, I said, why don't you do something like that? Because I've been after my kids, especially instrumentalists, I'm trying to have a food thing. I said, why don't you make up this, just do an arrangement with him and the church. Said, I don't know how to do that. And I said, well, you sit down and you play the song and you're just filling some gaps, and, you know. And I understand that everybody can't do that. But she thinks everybody can do that. I said, no. Everybody can't do that. So it's a real gift. Mm-hmm. And great job. Now, the end of the recital, if there's something to go in here. This is heavy, Thomas told me all this. I'm going to go with it. I'd like Christiana to come up for a minute for me, please, okay? And she doesn't know she can do all this because I've changed my mind on what we're going to do. But we're going to, hand out certificates to the kids and a little note and things. And I want her to hand out all the certificates as they come. The first come to me and get the note. But, yeah, go ahead.
I would like to say thank you very much that my three students could participate in this recital and for all the work that everyone put in to make it happen. I appreciate it very much that you included us. And I do appreciate the support that Scott and Naomi have provided us.
I have four new students that didn't play today because they just aren't taking the mention. But I have something a little bit for them. But they didn't play in the recital, so they don't get the certificate for the recital. But if you four could come up a minute, all the Bushmans, and let me give this to you. And then whisper in someone's ear because there's something there they need to know. The youngest, Nicholas. I don't mind when they come by fours, that's great. Sometimes they leave by fours too. Abby? Jacob? And Katie, but I need you here, but Katie. So if you ever look for a piano, don't look in the ads. Look at Craigslist, but ads, because they go fast. And Okay, now, starting from the youngest on up, Tabitha Vermonto. Now, you gotta get it from me first. That's the process. Olivia Vermonto. Before I do that, I began maybe 8 years ago. Man, what a difference I grow. Because it shouldn't be at all. She hid behind Mama's skirt. I was afraid of the spirit to death of me. No, I don't know that. I mean, she just was bashful and shy. No more. But anyway, Maggie's an eighth grader at Creekside, going into high school next year. She plays violin in the orchestra. I just saw yesterday that she won the most outstanding achievement award for the orchestra for Creekside. And she's beginning to really play classical. I let the kids choose their numbers, and that's why some were from movie themes, some were from musicals and things, and some were classical. But Maggie's been a real blessing. Jessica is in ninth grade at Wasatco. And I started playing with her, I think she's maybe in fifth grade. The last couple of years, I had the privilege of now teaching her clarinet lessons. West Ottawa has a tremendous band and music program. The best in the area, as far as I'm concerned. They really have that music program put together. So much so that they've got four bands in the high school. You know, most schools have two probably at the most, but they have four. And Jesse is one of the only three freshmen that auditioned and made the top band. She's done so well in piano too, both these girls have. And I just wanted to give them a special acknowledgement. And, you know, you can do whatever you want with them, but I still got trophies and I don't know what good they are. I don't look at them from high school days. And so keep these, frame them, bribe your mom and dad to pay you for them. No, 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 no. But congratulations, girls.
Time, you know, most of you don't know, but you go
to the doctor, you know, I'll let them just pray that things will be good. But you don't know. And so far, the Lord's been good to me, but I'll tell you, I don't know how long I'll be. But I look at these kids, and they're my replacement. In church, in teaching, in school, everything. And I don't, I'm going to put him on mine. Even a preacher will ask a kid if a person of mine talking about him. But Thomas Fremont told me something that has stuck in my mind. He said, I don't care if my girls become tremendous piano players. I want them to grow up becoming young ladies who are good citizens, who behave themselves, who know how to act, and if the music comes, great. And that's sort of what my philosophy is with the kids. I would tell a person if they come to me for piano lessons, a parent, and say, my kid's going to play in Carnegie Hall someday. I said, buddy, you've got the wrong teacher. Because that's not my philosophy of teaching. Someone's got to do that, but not me. I want them to enjoy themselves, have fun in what they're doing, and believe it or not, when you get up to go to play songs like the last three or four days, or even before that, that's when you'll start enjoying playing piano. You're down the hill with Jack and Smolner. Those songs, they aren't very fun. You got to name them something. When you can start playing some of the fun songs or some of the classicals, such as Sonata, Tune, and Pathetique, it's about Lily, and I've never met a new chick never played that. That's all you got to sing to her. So I got it. She's sick of Tobo now. So I'll show you. So, but they can. And it's really good. So I really appreciate your support and you as a family, you as families. Make them stick with it. They'll enjoy it. I told a girl yesterday, I said, you know what? I said that when you grow up, this gal's a junior, a year, a sophomore, when you grow up, go to college, you get married, have children, your children are going to think you're the greatest piano player in the world if you sit down and play while they're going to sleep. Because I thought my mother was the most fantastic piano player I've ever heard. She was good at one time. She wasn't very good when she was my age. But I thought she was good back in those days when I was younger. And sports have its place. I think it's one reason I relate to kids, especially public schools, and Christian school too. Because I have coached myself, I'm sympathetic towards it. But it's not the ultimate. I'm still playing music. I'm not playing softball or football anymore. And the Lord's been good to me. He's brought new families into my life. I'm amazed at it. I cry when one quits and four come in his place. I can't. So I just have to leave it to that. So anyway, thank you so much for coming. We do have refreshments. I see that gals have already gone there to prepare the lemonade and things, so that's good. I have a friend of mine also, not really related to anybody here, except probably the Fremontos, because they ask me for dinner all the time. So anyway, Bob Ross, a friend of mine, from church, is going to come up and pray for the refreshments as you're coming up. We got to lighten up a little bit, so I thought I'd leave you folks with one thing to remember. Guys, Bob came to me one day and said, I've got a problem. But he said it worked out good. He said, my wife lost all of my credit cards. He said, but I never reported it. Because the guy who stole them spent less than my wife. So, and now seriously, well, good, huh? And Marlene will kill me.
Thank you, Heavenly Father, for this beautiful day that you provided for this recital, Lord. And what a blessing. What a blessing to hear these young musicians playing and learning. I was so blessed. Father, continue to bless these young people as they grow up and are planning their churches, and they're going to be, they have been honoring you, Lord, most of all. And Father, so we just want to thank you for blessing us with music, and thank you for the director and Bob spending his time and teaching them. Father, we just want to thank you for those who brought the refreshments. And thank you for blessing the fellowship about the now. And continue to bless.